Okay, so this is a very small topic. So we are having some laparoscopy instruments, which we will be defining the usage of them. So this is a trolley which has been set. So these are the various laparoscopy graspers of various sizes and shapes. And this is the suction irrigation cannula. This is a laparoscopic specimen retrieval forceps. And these are the trocars of 10 mm, 5 mm and another 5 mm trocar. Introduce the instruments, and this is a bipolar or the Ruby dissector, and we also have a fluid filled syringe to do the bubble test after the insertion of the varies needle. So what is a varies needle? So varies is also called as an insufflation needle. So this is closed here, and we can move this knob by 90 degrees to make it open, and here we attach it to the tubing which goes into the CO2 insufflator, which is used for the creation of a controlled pneumoperitoneum. So this varies needle is a spring-loaded blunt perforated trocar and within a sharp cannula. So it is there, whenever there is a resistance is encountered, the sharp cannula will protrude. But when the resistance disappears, the blunt trocar will, and this prevents the injury to the viscera while insertion. So it is used to create pneumoperitoneum by CO2, and it is inserted into an inframlical small incision. Now this is an insufflator. It is used to create controlled pneumoperitoneum. It uses carbon dioxide cylinders, and after initially it is around 3 to 6 liters per minute, and after the pressure is stabilized, we put the flow rate to 0.5 to 1 liters per minute. Now these are the trocars and cannulas, which are 10 mm and 5 mm. So this is closed here, and if you move it this side, and you can attach the insufflation tubing here. So this is the cannula, and there is a sharp trocar inside, and this is the air inlet, and this trocar is removed, and then laparoscope is introduced after the removal of trocar from the cannula. Now how to introduce this trocar and cannula is, you have to lift the abdominal wall, and it should be introduced at an angle of 45 degrees. So if we were to introduce it directly, we can injure the common iliac artery or the external and the internal iliac artery. So lift the abdominal wall, and it should not be pushed directly, but pushed obliquely. And after this trocar and cannula has been inserted, the trocar is withdrawn, the cannula is left in place, and through which the laparoscope is introduced. So we have various sizes, 10 mm, 7 mm or 5 mm. This is the correct insertion method at an angle of 45 degrees. So if we were to insert it directly without making an angle, we can injure the vessels, and that can lead to torrential hemorrhage. Now coming to the laparoscope. So this is a Karl Strauss variety that has, this goes to the video monitor, and this goes to the light source, and this has usually an angle of 30 degrees here, and this uses a rod lens system.